So your first experience with creating a project probably occurs when you launch the software for the first time and the welcome screen appears. However, if you would like to see how to create a project through the welcome screen, I would refer you to the welcome screen video. But there are other instances when you could decide you want to create a new project from within the software. So there are several ways to do this. The fastest and easiest way would be to go to this first icon here in the top menu bar called New and click on it. So this opens the new project window. Another way to create a new project is by going to the File menu at the top and selecting New, or by using the keyboard shortcut Command N on Mac, and I believe it's Control N on Windows. So this brings up the same new project window. So let's create a new project. I'm going to give this project the name Episode 12, and you may have noticed that this name filled in for both the project name field as well as the project title field. And this is because the project name field is actually the name of your project file, whereas the project title is the title that will appear when you do a PDF export, for example. And although the name filled in for both fields, you can always click into the project title field and change it if you so desire. The next option is the project directory, and this of course is where you would like to save the project on your computer. If you are not satisfied with the default choice, you can always click on the Browse button and browse to a place on your computer where you would like to save your project. The next option is the project subtitle field. So this is a place where you can add additional titling as well as special mentions. So for example, our project title is episode 12. We could then make the subtitle holiday special. Next we have the camera size, otherwise known as the project resolution. So once again, if you're not satisfied with the default choice, you can always click on the arrow here to bring up the drop-down menu and scroll down until you find a resolution that you like better. The fields below it indicate the camera sizes, width, height, frame rate, and field of view, and these are not editable. In other words, you cannot click in them to change any of these options. What they are is not options, in fact, but just information on the camera size that you've selected. So the height and width are given in pixels, the frame rate is given in frames per second, and what the field of view indicates is the alignment of images when imported, so whether they're horizontally fit or vertically fit. If you would like to create a custom camera size, you can do that by clicking on this button here. And then in the resolution name field, you can give this new camera size a new name, so I'm going to call it custom. Then you can change the width and height to whatever you would like, so I'll make this 800 by 600, and maybe I'll have all the images come in vertically, and I'll change the frames per second to 30, or maybe something strange like 32, and select create. So now you see your new custom camera size appear in this drop-down list, along with all of its properties. And of course, if you would then like to delete this custom camera size, you simply have to keep it selected and then click on the minus icon here. And the last thing you need to do to create a new project is to click on the Create button.